Hi, let's talk about the common iliac arteries and their branches. In this video, we'll discuss the major branches of the common internal and external iliac arteries. We'll then go on to refine the branches of the external iliac artery by discussing the femoral, popliteal, and anterior and posterior tibial arteries. The abdominal aorta descends down through the retroperitoneum and approximately at the L4 vertebral level is going to split into the common iliac arteries. Those common iliac arteries ride around the crest of the pelvic cavity and then divide into external and internal iliac arteries. The internal iliac arteries are amazingly variable. They serve the pelvic viscera and the perineum and external genitalia. The external iliac arteries head out underneath the inguinal ligament, which we can see here, where they become the femoral arteries. As such, the external iliac arteries are ultimately going to serve the inferior anterior abdominal wall, the hip, and the lower limb. So let's take a look at the rough schema of the lower limb. So here we have the external iliac artery coming through, and then as it descends under the inguinal ligament, it transforms into the femoral artery. Over here on the cadaveric photograph here, if I were to draw in the inguinal ligament, it would be about there, and we can see this is roughly within the femoral triangle. We can see that the femoral artery is descending down the anterior hip, and it's there within this femoral triangle that the femoral artery is going to send off one of its first major branches called the deep artery of the thigh. That deep artery of the thigh, as we can see over here, is going to serve the posterior compartment of the thigh, whereas the continuation of the femoral artery down the anterior thigh will serve both anterior and parts of the medial compartment of the thigh. Now, that femoral artery is going to dive deep here, you know, it's going between the adductor group and quadriceps femoris, and it's going to cross over into the posterior portion of the thigh, and it's going to exit through the adductor hiatus, where it becomes the popliteal artery. That popliteal artery is best viewed on the posterior aspect of the lower limb. The popliteal fossa is that space behind the knee. Now, joints, especially mobile joints like the knee, benefit from a tremendous amount of anastomoses. So the shoulder joint is very well vascularized. The knee joint, the hip joints, they're all very well vascularized. In particular, with the knee, there are sets of arteries that anastomose with various branches of other arteries and with each other called the genicular arteries. So, genu means a bend or to knee or the knee, such as to genuflect. So, these genicular arteries specifically serve the knee. Continuing down inferiorly through the popliteal fossa, that popliteal artery is going to divide into an anterior tibial artery and a posterior tibial artery. So those are the terminal branches of the popliteal artery, anterior and posterior tibial arteries. The anterior over here. So here we are in the popliteal fossa, and we can see the popliteal artery descending down through the popliteal fossa, and it is going to divide into the anterior and posterior tibial arteries. The anterior tibial artery is going to serve both the anterior compartment of the leg, as well as it will be the major blood supply to the lateral compartment of the leg as well. That anterior tibial artery descends down, it crosses over, or I should say under, through the ankle, and it becomes, when it enters the dorsum of the foot, the dorsalis pedis artery. So the artery of the dorsal surface of the foot. It's then going to take a deep dive down through these metatarsals and end up on the plantar surface of the foot as the deep plantar artery. So just to follow that pathway, femoral to popliteal to anterior tibial to dorsalis pedis to the deep plantar artery. Now let's put a little pin in that for the time being. So that's where we left off. Now we can follow the posterior tibial artery. It's going to send a branch called the fibular artery, also known as the peroneal artery. Anatomists call various neurovascular elements and muscles fibular, whereas many clinicians refer to them as peroneal. You may call them either. So this is that fibular or peroneal artery. It is going to be the minor blood supply to the lateral compartment of the leg, keeping in mind that the anterior tibial is the major blood supply to that. The posterior tibial continues down. It's the major blood supply to the posterior compartment, superficial and deep of the leg. And you can see it continuing down, and then it goes posterior to the medial malleolus, and it's going to wrap around the calcaneus. And at that point, it's going to split into the medial and lateral plantar arteries. So let's follow that pathway. We have femoral to popliteal to posterior tibial, and then at the calcaneus, medial and lateral plantar arteries. The medial plantar artery runs along the medial surface of the plantar, the medial side of the plantar surface of the foot, whereas the lateral plantar artery runs along the lateral side of the plantar surface of the foot. So this lateral plantar artery and the deep plantar artery coming from anterior tibial come together in an anastomosis called the plantar arterial arch to fully serve that plantar surface of the foot. So we have ultimately a connection between downstream branches of anterior and posterior tibial arteries serving the foot. So that is the 10,000 foot view of the arteries of the lower limb, all derived from the external iliac artery. And that leads us to our assessment question of the video, and that is, which landmark indicates the transition of the external iliac artery to the femoral artery? Is it the adductor hiatus, the iliac crest, the inguinal ligament, the pelvic brim, or the popliteal fossa? Talking external iliac to femoral. Adductor hiatus, no, that's the transition from the femoral to the popliteal. Iliac crest, no, that's up in the hip, that's too high. Inguinal ligament sounds pretty good to me. You know, the external iliac artery runs under that to become the femoral artery, so that's good. Pelvic brim sounds bad to me, and popliteal fossa also sounds bad. So the correct answer to this is the inguinal ligament. Thank you very much for your time.